fine. So there are a lot of questions on rotational equilibrium. This topic is called rotational equilibrium, equilibrium for rigid body, same thing. Okay. First, let's do a couple of questions on finding out torque itself. Have you seen this question? Yeah, bro. It's a heart. That movie was a heart. I'm not making it up, see? It is there. हाँ क्या हुआ ड्रॉ करो दिस इज 15 न्यूटन 5 न्यूटन 10 Newton. This is 37 degrees. Okay?
So what about the last one?
This is 30 degrees. Any other information you need?
Where is the axis? Is it in the z direction?
अभी पढ़ने तो थे heart बना लिया. This 4, 4, 3, 6. Okay, here is the question. Calculate the total torque about the point O. ये रहा O.
So that arrow at the bottom, is that also a force?
हाँ, that is also a force. 20 Newton, sorry.
So is it 4 meter or centimeter?
Yeah. 3
centimeter. हाँ, centimeter ही होगा ना, suddenly. Height है, 4 meter long थोड़ी height होगा.
30 degrees.
But ये angle 30 है, ये आला. और कौन सा तेरे को दिख रहा है? Is there any other angle that can be 30?
That's not between 15 and 5.
ये तो around 90 type दिख रहा है ना?
ये 31.5.
इतना talk थोड़ी लगेगा दिल पे. हार्ट अटैक आ
21
अरे तुम लोग टॉक नहीं निकाल पा रहे हो ये कैसा दिल बनाया तुमने टोटली अनसिमेट्रिकल दिल्ली बनाया क्या तुमने ज्यादा
So is it 0.26 or 0.026, whatever. I don't know.
Whatever क्या होता है? Tell
I don't know the Z weight. 0.26.
No.
1.37.
No. 1.34. Yeah, it must be
1.6. I don't know which one is minus 3.
I don't know. Which one is going to So, where is the action?
Okay, do one thing, find out the torque of all the forces one by one.
That I got.
Yes.
That you got. Torque due to 5 Newton is?
Wait, it's...
Torque due to 5 is? 0. Passes through the axis. Right? Torque due to 15.
0.5.
How to get that?
15 into sine 37 is 0.06.
What? You can find a perpendicular distance like this. Guys, you can find the perpendicular distance, or you can resolve the forces like that to get the perpendicular component.
That's the
total.
Huh?
0.54. Yeah.
I am discussing here the solution, so you should pay attention. When I was asking what is the answer, you all said something, right? I listened and then I'm telling you, and now you're discussing among yourself, right? And bad manners. So torque into 15 is what?
0.5.
Perpendicular distance kya hai bhai? 6 into?
Sine 37
is perpendicular distance into 15.
By 100.
Because it is in centimeter. Torque due to 10 newton is what?
Minus zero point four.
This angle is 60 degree.
This angle is 60.
So the
other thing is 30.
This is 20 cos 60 into 4 by 100. Okay. Now this force, no rotation, this force like this, that force in this direction, this one in that direction. So this plus that minus this. 0.54 is the answer. Okay? Clear, all of you?
So suppose torque, like we write 0.54 newton meter.
Newton meter. N dash M. That's it. पूरा नंबर मिल जाएगा, ठीक है? Any doubt? No doubt. क्या डाउट है बोल?
Right the cos is then suppose like sine and then only
see cos or sine don't remember like that. You need to find perpendicular component of the force which is perpendicular to this line. Okay? So this is 60 degree. So 20 cos 60 is along this line, right? If you consider this angle 30, then it comes out to be sine 30. Sine 30 cos 60. Same. If two lines are like that, angle is theta, the component is cos theta times. Okay. Any other doubt? Quite out here. Answer is 0.54. Please write down center of gravity. Write down the definition of center of gravity. Center of gravity is different from center of mass. Center of gravity is a point which can be considered as if entire weight of the object is applied from that point. So earth is pulling the entire object from that single point. It will behave like that. Are you getting it? Any doubts? Right? So what will be the torque because of gravity about the center of gravity?
Zero.
It should be zero. Please write down torque because of gravity about the center of gravity should be zero. Any doubts? No doubts.
So why is the center of gravity not the center of mass? You said it's not always.
That is what I was about to do. Any other doubt? Any other? No. So let us use a definition and find out where the center of gravity lies. Okay? So this is an irregular shape and size of the object. Looks like a car. So let's say this is the center of gravity. According to definition, entire mg should act from here. Okay? And I can consider as if the entire rigid body is made up of small point masses. Is there any doubt on that? Okay, so let's say this is the point mass of mass m1. So m1g, alright, so m1g, this is m1g, there will be m2g. I am splitting the entire mass into multiple masses. This will be m3g. Okay? Alright? Now suppose this distance, this is your R2, this is your R1, this one is your R3. Okay? So torque about the center of gravity should be zero according to definition of center of gravity. Torque because of the gravity force about the center of gravity should be zero. Okay? So what it is? R1 cross M1G. Let's say G is varying everywhere. Okay? It's a big object. Gravity is G1, G2, G3. M1G1 plus R1 cross M2G2 and so on, divided by, no, that's it. Okay? Right? This should be equal to zero. What?
It is R2.
Okay, any doubts? Now, the direction of G is constant. Alright, because of which I can write it at like this. M1 R1. Direction of G is fixed. And if G is constant, let's say, if G is constant, then I can write it as equal to M1 R1 plus M2 R2 and so on cross with vector G is equal to zero. Getting it? Okay, and this means what? The bracket term is equal to zero. Are you getting it? So where the origin is if bracket term is zero? The bracket term is what? Summation of Ri Mi. Summation of Mi Ri, and I know that summation of Mi Ri divided by summation of Mi is R center of mass. Okay, so it is a point. This is a point. This, if I multiply and divide by summation of all the masses, this and here is total mass. I multiply and divide by the total mass. Okay, so this bracket term is basically, this should be equal to zero. And what is zero? Zero is the center of gravity as well as center of mass. Because we have assumed, when we started, we have assumed, let's say this is the center of gravity. From there only capital Mg is applied, let us say. And according to definition, net torque should be zero about that point. That is what we have done. So it is a point which has M1 R1 plus M2 R2 and sum of all that should be equal to zero. okay, and that point is actually the center of mass. Alright, so if acceleration due to gravity g is constant throughout the rigid body, then center of gravity and center of mass will coincide. Please write down. If small g is constant throughout the rigid body, if small g is constant throughout the rigid body, then center of gravity and center of mass will coincide. Then center of gravity and center of mass will coincide. Full stop. Gravity force on a rigid body. Gravity force on rigid body can be considered as a single force of m into g magnitude vertically down acted through the center of gravity. Fine. So if there is a rigid body, capital Mg will be applied through the center of gravity, and if nothing is said, you please assume that center of gravity and center of mass will coincide, because assumption of g being constant for entire rigid body is very common, right? Usually it is same only. Okay.